Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Final Fantasy. In the last episode, we did something. We beat some bosses. We're in the Lifespring Grotto. If you look, I am level 90. Level 90, because in between episodes, this was weeks ago, mind you, so if I'm a little fuzzy on the details, it's because it's been a little while. But I came through here after we defeated Atomos, and we got to level 20, and we were roughly around level 60, I think. And I got ripped to pieces by these bosses here. There's two. There's one here, and there's one on the other side. Just take my word for it. I don't want to walk all the way over there. Yeah, I got ripped to pieces by both of them. So I went and leveled up to around level 70, maybe level 75-ish. And I was like, yeah, there's no way that's going to happen again. And I went through all 20 floors again, and they ripped me to pieces again. So I went and leveled up to level 90. I still may get ripped to pieces, but I think I'll have a better chance this time. Hopefully. But yeah, let's go in here. Let's see what this guy has to say. I am that which follows Omega. Okay. And this is Shinryu. He is a dragon, of course. So let's start setting up and getting ready to not die, hopefully. Not dying is one of my favorite things to do. That hurt quite a bit. Now, this guy is very tough. He hurt me a lot. He killed me very quickly last time I fought him. I don't know if I'm going to beat him this time either, but we're going to try. I don't really have a new strategy, it's just I am a higher level now. He still hits really hard. he also has, like, flare, I believe. He's got some nasty stuff. So now we're gonna try healing. Hopefully he doesn't kill Pac-Man or anything. And we're gonna start tempering. Thunderbolt. That's not the worst thing I've seen. Still pretty bad. But hopefully we can bounce back from that. Nice. We're gonna continue to heal. And you're gonna temper, Mr. Duck. Ouch. And with that, we should be roughly where we need to be for this. So, I think I'm gonna heal. I'm just gonna use it. I know we don't need it, but hopefully he'll get his attack off first. And you, we got a Judgment Staff. I'm not sure if I even remember to mention it in the last episode. We got it for defeating Atomos. And since then I've had to fight Atomos two more times. So Vivi has a Judgment Staff equipped, and we also have two more in reserve. And it uses Flare when used as an item. Oh, speaking of Flare, he's using it on us. That hurt a lot. But we can also use Flare, and Flare is pretty much the best magic in the game. So, that's nice. And this is going much, much smoother than the last time I fought him. I still don't know if we'll win, but we're on a much better path than last time. Oops. And we're just gonna keep doing this. And hopefully soon he will die. I don't know how much health he has. Probably a whole shit ton. But, that's okay. I keep doing that. He's really not doing nearly as much as he was last time. He was really kicking my butt last time. But if we just keep up the strategy we're using right now, it seems like we'll take him out. Oh, I did it again. Yeah. It looks like he's like doing a couple attacks, then maybe Thunderbolt and then Flare. Nope, it doesn't matter, we won't even get to see. We did it. Which is fantastic, because I died too many times to this guy. And he gave us Ragnarok, that's awesome. Let's hope that that's better than the Excalibur. It is, and it gives us Evasion, oh my. Well, I am actually happy for once. And a Hero Shield, oh my, that sounds good as well. Let's check that out. Oh, good lord. That raised his evasion so much. And it wards off status ailments. You know what? I am no longer mad at this place. Except for the fact that I do actually have to go through all 20 floors once again to fight the other boss. So, I am going to meet you back down there for the next boss. I will be right back. Okay, so I'm not exactly back down at level 20 to meet you for the next boss, but I am on the floor where we fight Gilgamesh. It's level 5 on this playthrough, but it's random, so could be anywhere within the 20 floors. And I figured since I've fought Gilgamesh probably like 4 times now, I should actually show him. So, it says, I've finally found it, the object of my search, a weapon without peer. Eh? Who's there? You're after my sword, aren't you? Let's see how you handle the mighty me, and by me I mean Gilgamesh, and by handle I mean die. So, this is Gilgamesh. You always fight him on this floor, whether it's floor 5 or floor 10 or floor 800, it doesn't matter. He's not that tough. I usually don't even use the strategy. But, you may want to. I mean, he is still tough. He just hit me for 600 there. I don't think I've seen that before. So, yeah, I may have wanted to, but it's not that big a deal to me. Yeah. So, like I said, I just felt like I should show him off. I guess we'll just throw on Proterra just in case. And, yeah, I mean, he's cool. Gilgamesh is... he's not in every Final Fantasy game, but he's in a lot of them, and he's usually a pretty fun character in them. They usually make him a little goofy, but still fun. I could actually probably have Dizzy and Vivi use the flare, the judgment staff as it were, because I have two of them. But it doesn't matter, because he's done, and he always drops Genji gloves, so there you are. And so yeah, I will meet you down at the bottom floor now, for real. So be right back. Okay, I am down at the bottom floor now. We are all healed up. I used a dry ether on Dizzy, so we could have some magic as well, because I was running pretty low. And here we are going to fight this guy. 1,000 years it has been since a challenger stood before me. Show me the power you possess. Defeat me if you can. And this is Omega. Omega is a tough bastard. But we're going to do the same thing that we always do. And hopefully it'll all work out for us. Oh good, he missed. It is always good when the boss misses. So let's continue on. Let's get some Invisera up. And let's also get haste on... Who did I just use it on? Oh well. Oh good, I think I used it on the right person. So now that that's done, we're going to just try to keep the heals up. And temper. Yeah, see, we're still not doing much damage because he has a lot of defense, apparently. But, that's okay. Let's heal again. And temper Pac-Man. Ugh. That's a painful attack. So, they're not going to be doing a whole lot of damage, but it's better than nothing. And we're just going to keep it up the same way we did with Shinryu. Oh no, not again. Luckily that does a pretty decent amount of damage. I would have other people use it as well, but I'm just not confident that it would do more damage than their physical attack. It might though. I mean, Duck's not doing a whole lot of damage. But I think I'm gonna stick with the what we're doing, and I mean, as long as we keep it up and don't die, it may take a while, but we will get it done. And I think we have actually already seen all of his attacks. Could be wrong. All the ones I've seen already before. Anyways. That one right there is the most devastating, I think. And he can use it, just spam it, which is not great. But I have 999 magic when I came into this fight, so I can just spam heal, which is nice. And I'm pretty upset with the fact that I had to level up a whole shit ton just to do this. But I guess it's kind of good at the same time. I mean, from the second shrine to this third shrine, it was a huge step up in difficulty. so I don't really like that. And I have no idea what to expect from the last shrine. But, I mean, optional stuff should be more difficult, so I'm not too upset about that. Hopefully this guy's almost done though, because as much as I love doing the same thing over and over and over again, and messing it up even, it's kind of boring to watch. Did it without having to go through the magic one first. I cannot imagine that there's too much left in him, but you never know. They could have just given him like a trillion, million, billion, zillion health, and they just expect you to deal with it. Damn it. I have blasted through quite a bit of my MP though, so I'm starting to worry. Because once I run out of MP, I mean I can use a dry ether I guess, but I mean that just means that this boss is tough as nails, and that doesn't give me hope for the next shrine, really. My goodness. He could die at any time. I would be okay with that. And it worries me when he hits Pac-Man with that attack that does like 700 damage, because I can't heal enough to negate that. So if he hit him again, we'd be screwed. Especially when he hits Dizzy like he just did, because Dizzy's our healer. So hopefully he does not kill either of them. Holy shit. That is not good. I am going to pass on using a judgment staff so that I can heal Vivi. I do not want him to die. Oh, thank Jesus. That was hard. Well, it wasn't hard, but you know what I mean. It was more difficult than it needed to be. And for that, we got the Muramasa, whatever. It doesn't matter. We can't use it. Because it's for a ninja. Which I don't have, obviously. But that is it for the Lifespring Grotto, or whatever the hell this place is called. So, that is actually going to do it for this episode. I will meet you in the next shrine in the next episode. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and goodbye.